All right, so our opponent actually no-showed us in round two of this eight man, so we're straight onto the finals. I figure it's not a big deal since you guys will have gotten to see three matches anyway, and the first two matches were pretty long. All right, no mulligans here. So are we sticking with Island first, since it
Yep.
worked so well last time?
Casey's also on the Demir train.
Yeah, he did play a blue land turn one, so.
Oh, it looks like the Mirror Mash.
Interesting. So I think in this
Play
case I
Auger.
do want to play
What?
Auger. He's not. There's. Oh, he plays Geist. That would be bad.
No, I'm just thinking I want to cantrip both these Azorius charms just in case we whiff.
Are we that unlucky? I
We're
guess
pretty
we are.
unlucky.
The Geist argument is also valid. If he plays a Geist here, it's a catastrophe. Cavern Geist. Yep. Story of my life. Oh, Beast.
Beast.
So he's playing Reduce Bant deck?
It also means he has no more lands in his hand, or only caverns.
Yeah, pretty much. Can't imagine many
Here you can
lands.
play Auger.
Could he play Jace?
No.
Some versions of Reed's
We have
deck
Detention
did
Sphere.
have that, but yeah, we have Sphere, so I guess.
And we can't counter or Thrakdusk anyway. So it's fine to tap out for Sphere next turn.
Right. Perfect. Supreme Verdict. Just what we needed. Yeah.
Another Augur.
Yeah, I
Try
agree.
to hit a thing twice.
That would be nice.
Just put some effort into it. Alright.
I didn't put enough
Value
effort
effort.
into it. I need to work on my effort.
Just gonna play Thrakdusk, then we're gonna die.
We're not gonna die.
I really hate how good Thrakdusk is.
It is kind of frustrating, yeah. It was supposed to be good against Delver. It was unplayable against Delver and ruined every other
Alright, just
format.
play a plains and sneak through two.
Yeah, that's how I feel. Am I chumping at all? I don't think so.
Chump is fine.
I don't
I
like
like a good
chumping
chump.
because should I have swings for two main phase? Is that what you're saying? I don't think
No,
so,
not
right?
at all.
Okay.
Are you hoping to draw a third Augur?
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping for.
I mean, I guess you can just.
Like, it's I'm gonna have the chump block available to me later. It's also like if I want to resto one and he kills one, or you know, things could happen. Things could just happen.
Gonna rest in.
Then I can just Supreme Verdict. He knows I have it. He's thinking about it.
Ooh, I forgot that we had all these nice cards.
Yeah, we have a lot of nice cards. I want to pay two life here, but I don't know why.
I'd advise against it.
You would?
You're not gonna be able to single bait anything for one.
I pro. You never know, like.
And this like puts you into 15, which is a 3-turn clock.
It's true, but I feel like the two life might make the difference.
And us dying?
No, like we could resto a Augur and hit like a draw
Okay,
spell.
that's actually a reasonable point. Haven't gotten in some attacks.
I don't know. Am I blocking and restoing, or am I restoing and blocking?
Pick one.
My current leaning is blocking and restoing.
Alright, I like that better. Because you can always block later.
Yeah, that's what my thinking is. If he counters the resto, it's slightly annoying, I guess. But who cares? I wanted to chump block anyway, so that's fine.
Well, if he counters, it's fine. You just play either of them.
Yeah, that would be sweet. His deck probably does not have a whole lot of answers to Aetherling. Like, Supreme Verdict might be the only one. It looks like he is trying to counter it. Oh,
Holy
jeez.
Vegas.
Now I just wanna blink the other Augur.
Do you?
No, I'm gonna blink this one.
You gotta wait for you to blink it.
Yeah, he definitely could have. Also, I don't get why he wants Selesnya Charm to be a burn spell. Like, I could charm the Thrakdusk now.
Yeah, you could.
I'm not going to. I don't care about my life total. This seemed awful.
Now, if you draw a card, you can rest it, and then the Wrath isn't even that good.
That's true. I don't really
How does
care.
this? Oblivion already? Good thing I had Detention Sphere.
Yeah, that's actually sweet, right?
No, it's actually good for him.
Why? So, wait, why is that good? Oh, well, now we're just slamming eighth ruling. Right?
Yeah, I guess so. But so we now, can't block.
We're going to block with an auger.
Yeah.
I guess I could poke him for one, but I'm not even sure it's worth it.
Do not do that.
Yeah, it seems safer to just sit back, relax, and enjoy the flight.
Can I have another Celestia Charm?
I want when he attacks with Thrakdos, I'm going to double block with augers.
Why? Don't do that.
Just because Charm does less damage.
Then it kills both. Block with one.
It's
foolish.
I guess so. I don't know. I feel like something bad might happen. Eh, nothing bad happened.
Even if you knew they had Celestia Charm, you'd
block. Yeah. Would I? I guess so. Like, trading an auger for 3 life probably isn't worth it.
Oh, this is a Sphinx.
No, it's he has an Aetherling.
Okay. Can you do some sort of verdict sphere trick?
No.
Wait, can you not?
No, they're both sorceries.
You exile in your main phase sphere.
He blanks.
And then second main phase, it comes back.
No, it comes back end of turn.
Oh, okay. So we're just dead.
I mean, what we have to do is perpetually interact with his Aetherling while attacking with ours, like Azorius Charm and things like that, or Revelate for a lot.
Okay.
Like, I can go Snapcaster Azorius Charm, Resto Snapcaster Azorius Charm. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. I mean, try.
But I don't think I have to make this unblockable to attack with it.
You can just block that blink.
But that's so gutsy if I have Azorius Charm.
Okay.
Well, I do have Azorius Charm. Now that I mention it. So can I do any pumping?
Yeah.
So I have to Snapcaster Azorius Charm, that's 4 mana. And I think I want to blink this to leave it up as a blocker.
Okay.
That's a 5th mana, and I want to have a blink up that's a 6th mana. So I can pump for 2 in theory? I don't get to keep up any syncopate, but who cares?
You do want to deal a damage, so yeah.
Maybe I can only do it for 1. Because I'm going to have to pay a mana to make it so that the Aetherling doesn't die to the Thragtusk.
Okay. Do you have enough blue for Azorius Charm?
I do. Because I can just do -1/+1 to make it.
Okay.
Yeah. This vaguely makes sense.
Alright, I think this might actually work.
You do?
Yeah.
If he has nothing, I think we're a favorite, but I don't think he has nothing.
Could also attack with the auger.
Then he just blocks.
Then you have Azorius Charm.
Then he can blink.
Oh, okay.
Like, the only reason I could do this is because I can force him to use mana.
Well, he could also just trade them.
Yeah. This will be interesting. If he doesn't pump it all the way, I can also just take it. I don't know if that's psychopathic or not. I don't think it is, because then I can just Revelation for a lot.
Alright, I guess I like
I'm going to make him go all the way. He could go all the way.
Alright.
I have no blockers. This is going to be an exciting game, one way or another. Bant, won the last Moto PDQ, right? Or did it?
No,
it won. No,
I read what they did.
It won one of the recent Moto PDQs, I think. Oh, John Cassari got third with it at that Moto PDQ.
I don't know if he was even playing it.
He was playing Bant, though.
Yeah.
He's just hitting me for 5? Alright.
Wait, why didn't you do it?
I'm gonna Revelate.
Okay.
I wanna save this if possible. This is like my ace in the hole.
But you have 2 of them.
I know, but I have 2 aces in the hole. I have to make this race work.
Okay.
I need help to make that happen. Am I going for the full amount, or am I leaving Aetherling out?
You can't do anything here.
Yeah, probably not, yeah. I also really want to hit land drops. Well, not that badly. Alright, this time I will make it unblockable. So how much can I hit for this time safely? I still do want to blink it out. And then it's... So I guess 1 again? Or shouldn't it be 2 now? After Snapcaster is Aureus Charm. Blink it out. And no, for some reason it's only one.
For two.
Wait.
Because you can just pump the toughness. You don't need to use a blue.
Okay, so I have to Snapcaster Azorius Charm, pump the toughness, and blink it out. Yep. And then blink it out a second time in case he has Verdict. I guess I don't really need that. I'll pump again, I'm feeling lucky.
Well, does the...
I can also just... Actually, you know, I'm not just going to not blink it out. If I have to Chomp Augur on Thrakdust, that's fine.
Alright.
I have to get aggressive here.
I don't know how much I like that. What if he has Celestia Charm?
Augur still chumps Thrakdusk effectively.
Yeah, sure, that's fine.
So can I go one more then? I still have enough for Snapcaster Azorius Charm. Yeah. I have to do stuff like this, right?
I mean, you could leave like Syncopate up for one.
No.
For his Sphinx's Revelation.
Can't worry about stuff like that.
And you do want to make him use his Aetherlight unblockable now.
Well, right now I can just block. I'm gonna, if he attacks, I'm gonna Snapcaster Azorius Charm, and then I'll have to use Aetherling Unblockable, or I can just block both.
Okay.
I don't know. This is really tough. I'm really counting on him having nothing, which is not something I like to do. But.
Well, I mean, his hand could just be like Verdict, Verdict.
But yeah, that would be excellent. There's some cards that I wouldn't mind playing against, besides like lands and Farseeks and whatnot. Like, another O-Ring would be fine. So I think if he doesn't do anything, I Snapcaster his Aureus Charm. Oh, he is making it unblockable. Okay. So I guess I just declare Augur as a...
Just declare Augur.
So weird. So if he passes here, I just let him.
Yeah, this looks like a Celestial. This looks like something.
Probably.
I'll probably do one more.
There's no way he's not going to make me act. Yeah. Come on.
Probably has something.
Yeah, I mean, this wasn't an aggressive play, but I didn't have a choice in the matter, I don't think. The conservative way just wasn't going to get the job done. Like, I could have left up Syncopate for a tiny bit more. Just blink out. Blink out. You can do it. Yes!
Hey, I think we're probably going to win the game now.
Yeah, me too, actually. It's very weird. One thing I was thinking about is instead of Azorius Charming his guy, I can also Azorius Charm Lifelink. The problem is if he has a charm then I just die on the spot. So, it's a bit scary.
I like this play better.
Yeah. It does give him more time to draw something, though. He might Selesnya Charm Trample here.
Yeah, I'd be fine with that. He should be saving it to exile your Aetherling.
Yeah, definitely. At some point, maybe I should just play around that and just unblockable and attack for four. I guess it doesn't really make sense since it takes a turn off the clock. But well, I guess this turn I could attack for four. It's probably better to this turn attack for eight and then... That way, if he draws a Celestial Charm on the last turn, he gets... Well, no, this turn I have to do the Resto... It's actually more complicated than that. Because this turn I have to do the Resto Snapcaster thing, and that costs a lot of mana. Six, to be precise. So this turn I probably just unblockable and attack for four. Okay... A funny draw. Okay, so
you need to leave up
six to do the rest of Azorius Charm thing. I'd like to leave up at least one so I can't get verdicted.
Okay, so leave up seven.
Two, four, six, seven. So that leaves me with two. Is it actually worth pumping for two, or should I just attack him for four and leave up, like, syncopate for one or something?
Well, you can blink. You could also blink Aetherling to block.
Oh, that's a good point.
That way you don't lose the Celestia turn.
The other thing is, if he has Resto here, I could right now I could syncopate it for two, Resto, Snapcaster, Azorius Charm.
Okay.
So maybe I should just attack and not leave up. Not blink this.
Well, then you could just Resto on his main phase.
It's not as good as if he Resto's end of turn. If Resto's end of turn, I die.
Okay.
I don't know what you think. I kind of like just unblockable pass.
But this way you lose two Celestia turn.
Not necessarily. I can decide based on what I draw if I want to just unblockable for one more turn. Sure. Or I also might just be able to attack him with everything on the backswing. I don't know.
Alright, yeah, pass.
Yeah. I like this. It's a scary time.
Oh.
It might be on Angel. I could have upkeep this Resto, that was one thing I was thinking about, but I don't think there's any, like, anything that would really make that good.
So if you want to play around Celestia Charm, you can double block.
If he doesn't unblockable this, I think I'm just going to block this with a Snapcaster.
That's good. But he's going to unblock it.
You would guess so. Okay. So now I cast Resto. I guess casting Resto after blocks is, like, strictly bit. No, then he could Azorius Charm it. So I should cast Resto now. Yes? If I block and then Resto, then he can Azorius Charm.
Okay.
Or he could Selesnya Charm. So both of those plays make Resto now better. Alright, Resto now it is. He actually can't syncopate this, because he can syncopate the Azorius Charm, I guess. They'd have to tap 5 to... and I can only get him for 3 back. Yeah, he would have enough.
I don't think that he has... I don't think that you can
play the
Celestia Charm.
You don't think so?
No. I don't think that you should play around it.
I'm not convinced I can beat it, but... if I... because the other you have to remember, he has to present a lethal threat right now. He has to tap 2 more mana to pump the Aetherling.
Okay.
So he's... I think I could... let's say I block Thragtusk with Resto.
Okay.
Then he can't Selesnya Charm to kill me.
Okay.
So he has to just pump this twice to make a lethal threat. I charm it.
Okay.
He blinks. Then I...
Actually, yeah, that play is fine.
I'm not sure. So what do you think I should do? Block Resto on Thragtusk?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, Resto resolved. And Snapcaster seems like the logical target. Is Snapcaster not the logical target? I could target Aetherling. I blinked a spirit before for fun, so anything's within my range.
I mean, the situation's slightly different in that we're just dead if you don't do it.
As opposed to before when we were winning by so much we could have literally discarded our whole hand and sacrificed our whole board and still won very easily.
Yes.
Okay, that is kind of different, I suppose. Alright. Would I like to use the ability? Yeah, I guess so. Target, I guess, is a reassuring. Alright, so Resto is blocking Thragtusk. I just want this on the record. And that is the only thing blocking Thragtusk. Is that what we decided?
Yes.
Alright. How about nothing block Thragtusk? Oh, no, then we decided I lose to...
Then you want to force him to do something also.
Yeah. I'm with you. Yeah, him tapping mana is crucial with Syncopate in our hand. Absolutely crucial. Oh, Resto blocking this does give him a token, which...
No, we want that to happen. Sorry, right. I can't Resto game line.
That's true. If he tries to resto gain life now, he does have enough mana to pay for syncopate, but at least we'll know about it.
You could, Azorius Charm the Phyrexus, but then you die.
Well, that doesn't sound very good. That doesn't sound very good at all.
You could.
At that point, I probably just have to rip something to answer Aetherling. Which is, you know, not too unlikely. Wait, he's passing? Why? Should I just let this happen?
Of course.
Well, no, maybe I just charm this anyway, because there's no reason to give him the...
No, you'd rather draw a card and try to draw another one.
Okay. I guess that's valid.
And leave up something.
Yeah, oh, right. That is valid. Alright. Am I even going to draw a card? Is it better to just leave up syncopate for the full amount at all times?
I'd definitely draw a card.
Okay. Well, let's see what he does. That'll give us some perspective.
I guess
it'll be nothing. I'm not so sure. Yeah, that's what I'm nervous about. That would make a lot of sense based on the way he's played.
And does? Well, you just draw a card, draw another Azorius Charm, play Aetherling, and then you win.
Well, that sounds easy. Wait, why do I have to play Aetherling?
To present a link.
So I am cycling this?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll trust you.
If he wants to play around Sync, he'll have to, like, Sphinx of Revelation for a very small amount.
Yeah, that's true.
You think that's good.
So I have to unblockable this.
Yeah.
And I'm just shoving?
Yeah.
Alright. This is the moment of truth. Yeah. Azorius Charm?
Okay, then. That's an idea.
My guess is nothing, but you asked what he could possibly.
My guess is Celestia Charm. He just seems like the type of guy.
Can I actually get there if I. No, not quite. Well, maybe. 8. No, it costs a lot of mana. I was thinking if I could power it down and then power it back up again. But. That is an option. Is it not an option?
It is.
You just find it funny? Oh, no. Oh, no. Yeah, he did have it. So now I'm just think-twicing to find an answer? Is that right? I could do the power down thing.
One, two, three.
Man, you know, if I had blocked Snapcast...
Wait, he opened your resto? You could...
Oh, I could have Detention Sphered and then Lifelinked or something.
Oh, you're saying if you kept the resto around, it would have been good enough?
Maybe. But if I blocked Snapcaster on Thragdusk, he would have just Lesnia Charmed from Trample.
So I told you couldn't beat one.
Yeah.
Yeah, just think twice. You're only out as Azorius Charm.
Is that right? Or land. Oh, so now I can't afford to blink this.
What do you mean? How is a land good?
Well, I can land, think twice. You know what I'm saying?
I guess so.
I might as well play to it, right? Like.
Sure. You only have one left in your deck.
Look.
You already played land this turn.
Oh, well then I'm just dead.
Alright, just concede.
Man, that was frustrating.
Well, I thought that we were going to lose the whole time.
Yeah, I thought we were going to lose for most of it, I would say. At the very end, I thought we were going to win.
Don't bring in Geist, he has so many creatures.
You think?
Yeah.
Geist is still pretty sweet. This card has to be good, right?
Yeah.
What isn't good? Charm isn't great.
Charm is excellent.
Charm is excellent?
Yeah. I think that Augur.
Is O-Ring good? O-Ring seems good.
You can get Verdicts.
Oh, that's probably a good idea.
Not all of them.
I think I can get all of them.
He has Cavern Thragdusk resting.
Is Snapcaster good? Not really. I just want cheap stuff.
We're gonna die to creatures.
No, we're not.
You underestimate.
I like this setup where we're just all spells.
Alright, whatever.
Do you wanna try
it? Do you even like the resto? Can we just cut the resto? Or Verdict?
I don't like Verdict.
Resto does nothing.
Resto does do nothing now. How should we build it? Geist is good.
Well, I think if we have Geist, then we need Resto.
I think Geist will be good.
Alright, then also void and rest then. Take out these oblivion rings.
You think?
Yes.
We also have to win quickly because of the clock, so that's another argument.
Cut a Azorius charm, I guess.
Why do you like Detention Sphere so much but hate Oblivion Ring?
Alright, cut Detention Sphere. Add Azorius charm and Snapcast.
I think O-Ring is no, actually... Snapcast. You just hate O-Ring? Okay.
Alright, yeah, this is actually good.